Why, hello there, and welcome back. I'm Doseku, and this is still Daydreaming Derpy. When we last left off, we looked at a few differences from the opening from the demo to the full version. Today, we're going to dive into one of the dream worlds. Yay! Alright, so I have seen a gameplay video of this. I believe I know what's behind this door, so we're not going to go there. Instead, we're going to go into the muffin base door. Let's see what Dinky's thinking of today, yeah? Of course. Oh. Huh. Well, it's just the tutorial area again. We don't need to be there. But what is Doctor Who's thinking of? Oh, never mind, it's just a TARDIS. We'll let that go for now. Instead, let's go in here. Heck yes. Huh. The music stopped. Okay. Oh! Alright, I'll admit, these character portraits are starting to grow on me a little bit. They kinda do fit this game's style pretty well. Should we be a little miffed? Yeah. And yes, that it is, the Inspector Gadget theme playing in the background. Unfortunately, you can tell it loops. That's one of the failings of this game, is the music very, very obviously loops. No, we cannot stay in here forever. But by the way, this is a Moondancer. If you recall from the last episode, Moondancer was running the used bookstore with Twilight. I kind of wonder what our talents are supposed to be. It's clearly not doing the job correctly. But whatever. Now, of course, at this point, we obviously can't deal with ghosts by ourselves, so we're going to befriend Moondancer and make her part of our party. Yeah, I already told everyone that. Yeah, let's go bust some ghosts. So now that we got our new party member, let's take a look at her. Let's see, we got Methods, transferred in paper, cast away. Ooh, cast keep away. We love that. That's a good spell. Theorize is definitely going to come in handy because it allows us to regenerate HP. Some call it gold fever. Nice. Confused target most of the time. Alright. Does she have any uniforms? No. Maybe we can give her more uniforms later on. You know what? We gotta save now that we got a new friend. Yes. Huh. Alright, so here's the thing. When you're interacting with Dinky in the dream world, there's really no button you can press on the gamepad to actually interact with him. Oh, I'm sorry, her. For these kind of interactions, you actually do have to hit space on the keyboard if you are playing with the gamepad. Huh. I would have thought something scary would have happened there. Oh well. There's nothing up here. Boo. Hey, it's Dinky again. Still can't interact with her with the gamepad. Yeah, locked from the inside. Nope. Alright. Now we got our team, we got some ghosts. Let's do this. So for this one, we're going to try out different outfits. Let's see, what do I want? Construction? We'll do construction later. For now, let's go as a magician. Yeah. Let's see, what else we got here? Theorize, lesser healing, magic bubble, trippy spell, greedy spell. Nah. I really don't see a need for greed at the moment. Because I don't see a need to give a character an extra turn. That may be my downfall later down the line. Ooh, that's kind of creepy. Well, we're out of magic. So let's try the mill mare, see what we can do there. Alright, let's go postal on them. Let's see, can't do greeting cards, but we can do junk mail. Now, the cool thing is, we actually have our health regen stamp on us, and if you've been watching carefully, we regain, was it, 11 health per turn? Which means we can ostensibly use the, postal spell as much as we want, or at least once per turn, and it'll be at no cost or HP. But something you learn quite quickly, especially with some of the other uniforms, is the fact that a straight up bop is actually much more powerful than the magic abilities. Huh. Interesting. So, I have to wonder, are these ghosts anything like the thought bubbles from the tutorial zone? Does everybody in Equestria love Daring Do? I know Rainbow Dash kind of, and I think Rainbow Dash might be Daring Do's only friend at the moment. Ah, okay. So now we got our end goal. We gotta go through that door. You know, as much as I love the Inspector Gadget theme song here, I really, really don't like how it's on a very, very short loop. I wish they added more to it. Or at least found something a little longer and found a way to make the looping not so obvious. Wow, somebody actually wrote a thesis on disliking Twilight. That's interesting. Bugging in 101, all you need to know about never leaving your comfort zone. It kind of makes you wonder if Moondancer doesn't like to interact with people. I mean, she has a book about staying at home and staying within her comfort zone. Maybe she's slightly antisocial. I guess that's why she likes books so much. Yeah, you're right. I do not want to know what's down the laundry chute. It's probably something naughty. Hey, boo! Alright, alright. So, we got more ghosts, that means different uniforms. Let's see. Maybe being a ponytoon will work. Oh. Oh, cripes. They actually have the ability to knock down our MP. Let's see. Maybe we can hurt them with a shrill note. And, let's do some MP regen. There we go. This should allow us to keep using our magic without fear. It looks like we get like 16 MP per turn. Okay, so it looks like the Ponyton's normal abilities, or normal hit, is actually kind of weak. No matter, we still won. Ooh, a bran muffin. Oh, come on, it's only a bran muffin. Oh hey, it's Owlicious. So, Twilight also ended up in the dream world, and she brought her pet with her. Interesting. Alright, so our next part of our quest is to turn down the lights so we can talk to Owlicious and find Twilight Sparkle. Oh, check this out. So if you look above, you see like two pictures on a shelf. One with Moondancer and one with Moondancer and Twilight. I thought it was a neat little touch. Yeah, we want to save. I know. Let's keep going. Look at this ghost try to hide. Come on. Oh. Well, that's a letdown. Avoiding the sauce. Oh, check it out. Perfect. Yeah. We know Dinky wants that. Come on, you can never be too old to read books. Are you a ghost? I swear, one of you are going to turn out to be ghostier soon enough. The best princess. Oh wow, it's another thesis. Huh. You know, you gotta kinda wonder how many princesses this place actually has. I mean, there's really no queens, although the closest you can get to it would be Princess Celestia, at least for the daytime. If you roll into nighttime, you get Luna. Then you roll over to, was it the Crystal Empire? There's another one over there. And then, I guess Ponyville has one, which would be, well, the Purple Horse. Get rid of furniture. You know what? Should we screw with this lamp? Yeah, let's do it. Heck yeah, we do. Oh, it's not that spooky. Look at that smug face. Of course we'll turn it off.
Whoa.
That was a great idea. That reaction was everything. Oh. Huh. The music stopped. And this is still not a ghost. Oh, there's one. Alright. So, we need to try a different uniform out this time. Yeah, let's do this. Alright, construction workers should make things a little easy. And, of course, I think I want to use Highcart's method. There we go. Now they can't touch us for a small bit. And we can bop them to heck and back. Ooh, let's check out Mod Rush though. Nah, I don't care about safety first. Holy crap! We can take 50 as construction worker? See, we're super, super strong. If you recall when we worked as magician or the ponytone, the best we could have done was like maybe 16 to 20. So, switch over to construction obviously gives us a much better advantage, especially since we don't have that much magic to actually work with. Oh, and check this out. I actually didn't notice this before, but Derpy is actually carrying an eye beam. And she's got safety glasses on along. Is that the earmuffs? Huh. Oh sweet, we're level 3. Still furniture though. Oh! That's... that's odd. Nah, we're good. We just want to save. Yeah. Now, if you recall, Owlicious wanted us to turn down the lights. And since we did that job for him, let's have a nice little chat and see what he has to say. Alright, yeah, kind of. I think we blew a fuse when we blew the lights. Oh. Ew. Ew. That's not right. Yeah, right? Come on. We know where this key will take us. Right over here. Oh, we are. It's the only way forward. Yeah, let's do this. Huh. Alright, so we did worker. What do we got left? Alright, Millmare. So let's see what happens if we bop. Oh. 80? How the heck is that stronger? Huh. Okay, so that's a weird thing to say, but we did find the two-prong key, which will allow us through the center door, and the lights came back on, so now we got the music again. Hmm. Ooh. And we can't go any further, so let's have some fun. Oh! Oh. Is that a stab at us? Okay. Alright, so we're actually at our first true boss fight. You know it's a boss fight because the music's different and we're fighting Moon Dancer's Anxiety, which is not the name of the form Twilight takes here. Honestly, I don't remember the name of this thing off the top of my head. I do know this form was at least taken once in one of the movies, but for the life of me, I can't remember what it's called. It's obviously an evil iteration of the princess, like how Luna has Nightmare Moon and Celestia has Dawnbreaker. Now, here's the thing, Anxiety here has a lot of HP. A lot of HP. But we're going to try to wear her down the best we can. I'm certainly glad we're using the, was it Hakate's thingy or whatever? Ooh, we got Dirty Foul. And I saw a Jacuzzi there. So one of my main intents of this battle is to maintain MP regeneration so we can continue to use our special abilities. However useful they might be against her. But Moon Dancer's default attack bop is actually kind of weak when compared to us. And Anxiety here is quite strong, but you know what? We're gonna throw some mad game at her and hope we can poison her. Wait, did we call her Blank Flank? Ooh, that is some bad insults. Uh, But we did in fact poison her, so that's good. Do I have enough for more insults? Yeah. And we use that. There we go. Perfect, she's still poisoned. I don't want to risk losing my health with the stress ball because that may mean I die. Ew. So close, come on. Just nether insult and lesser healing, that'll work. Oh, look at that, she changed her animation state. It looks like she's actually kind of low on HP. Perfect. So let's end this with a Wonderbolt. Let's see, we got Tornado. Would this do anything? Of course not. Alright, Thunderbuck. And healing, there we go. It's alright. Thankfully that poison is still doing its job. Bop. Nice. Although the bop was actually kind of weak. In fact, construction worker and millmare had way, way more attack power. I guess that's the end of that. Oh, right, yeah, of course. I forgot, we gotta learn our lesson for this dream sequence. So we have an interesting choice to make here. We can say that doesn't matter, or we can go, you matter. I'm kind of curious to see what this option gives us. Yeah, she's got a point. You don't want to be taking advice from her. What? So this is a good spot to stop for today. Thanks for watching, and join me next time as we see what new things the waking world has for us. I'll see you there.